So I did a video to find the second, third, fourth, etc. match, if you wanted to, from a list of matches. And I had a question, how to actually create something that will get us the last match. So we're going to do that again to work in both Google Sheets and Excel in this case. So I'm going to go to Google Sheets. The formula is going to be the same for both. So I'll copy and paste it here in Excel once it's done, so we can verify that it works. So I'm gonna get back to this. So basically what we have here is a list of company IDs. And for each company ID from this contact, we have possibly no matches or one or more match. So for example, if we look at this ID that ends with 330, if I copy that, if I go in here and search, see we find two matches from this list. So in this particular case, we would want to return the second match. And in this case, I'm going to do names, but you could do anything you want right from here. Now, the same way, if we go to the second ID, see we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So in this case, we need to return this last person from this list. So we need to always find the last match. So to do this, I'm going to go to companies here. And I'm going to start with filter function again. So I'll do equals filter. And what we'll do as a range for this filter, we'll go to contacts spreadsheet and basically get the list of names that we need returned. So in this case, that's going to be in this B column. I'm going to select the whole column B. Press F4 to make this absolute reference, comma. I want to filter by true and false statement that I'm going to get by taking this column A with this company IDs, again, F4 to make it absolute reference, and check if it equals to that list of company IDs, go back to companies and click on the first company in the list, this one, and close parentheses. Now, if you're in Excel, you come back and you click on this ID, it's probably going to add the name of the worksheet here in front of A2. You want to go ahead and remove that. Just keep this nice and clean like this. Just the reference to the cell without the worksheet name here that says companies. So at this point, if I hit enter, see, I will get matches to this company ID. So again, if we just go check this 3300, see, here is one, here is two. And those are the names we return right in here. So out of those names, I need the second one. So I would have to just go in here and do index, open parentheses, and then I'm going to go all the way to the end, comma, and give it the position of the item I need returned. So that would be 2 in this case. The problem is with that 2 is that only for this particular case, for this company, that 2 is valid, because sometimes it's going to be 2 matches, sometimes it's going to be 4, sometimes it's going to be 3. So we always need to figure out which one do we need to get. So in this case, it's going to be 2. In other cases, it's going to be something different. So for example, if I just drag this one down, see, this is not going to be accurate most likely, because if we check this ID and search in this list, there seems to be 1, 2, 3, 4 matches. So to get the last one, this one, that should be position number 4 in here. So as you can see, we can't really drag this formula just down just yet to get the results we need, because of that problem that position is going to change. Sometimes it's going to be 2, then it's going to be 4, then it's going to be something else. So now we need something that will get us those positions. Well, what we can do, we can create a logical statement in some product function to find how many matches we're actually able to find. To give you an example of that, I'm going to do right next to this. We'll incorporate it in our formula in just a second. I'm going to use some product because that's going to make my life easier to not have to do array formula brackets around this. So what I'm going to do as the array, I'm going to go to contacts and select this column A of company IDs. I'm going to do F4 to lock the range. And I want to check if that equals to this range to the company ID in the current row. So again, I'll go back to companies, So I'm going to click again on this company ID on the left, close parentheses. So again, if you're in Excel, when you click on this ID, it's probably going to say companies exclamation and then the reference. Make sure you get rid of that because otherwise you won't be able to sort your data later on. So I'm going to do this and hit enter. So let's see what it gives us. I'm going to just let it do whatever it does. See, it gives me 2 here, 4 here, 1 here. So this is actually giving us how many times it was able to match this ID. So what's happening is that we get this list of trues and falses when we do this logical statement. And every time it finds the same company ID, it gives us true. And every time it doesn't, it gives us false. So if it finds it 4 times, it's going to have 4 trues in this logical statement. And some product is going to take those trues and convert it to 1. And it's going to add them up together, so it's going to get 4. Now, in this first line, there are 2 of them, so it's going to get 2 trues. And 2 trues is going to basically take it as 2 ones. And it's going to give us 2 right here. So the total is 2. And then 4 and 2. So this gives us how many matches we have. And that's exactly what we need here. See, we have 2 here, then we have 4 here, and so on. So 0 means there was no match for this. So if I go back, copy this, and go back to this contacts and search, see, 0 matches. It's not able to find any match for that one. So there's nothing we can do about that one. There's no match. So all I have to do now, just go back, copy this sum product formula without the equal sign, hit escape, go back to my first formula and replace this hard-coded 2 with that sum product formula that gets me the position. And with this, I'm going to hit enter and drag this formula down. And I don't need this anymore. And there we have it. That should give us the last match. So at this point, I can just do if error to handle any errors, if I don't want those NAs to show up there. And I'll do if error, and in the end, I'll do comma and double quotes to make it blank in case there's no match, and drag this formula down again. And there it is. So let's just check a couple of these results to verify they actually work. So let's start with this one. Well, that one I remember, that's actually correct. Let's do this one. So that should be the latest match for this. So let's take a look. Yep, that's accurate. That's the latest match. Let's do this one. Apparently there's only one for that, which is this. So that's accurate, as you can see. Let's try this one too. So see, we got 1, 2, 3 matches, and the third one is this one, the latest match, and that's exactly what we got. So we're good on this. Now let's just finally verify that this same formula works in Excel. So we're going to copy this, hit escape, go back to our Excel worksheet. I'm going to go to the same tab here and just put my formula right in here, hit enter. So we seem to have a problem here, because that returns 2 results for some reason. So let's see what's going on here. It doesn't actually return us the match we need. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna quickly test this sum product formula on its own. So I'm gonna copy that, hit escape, go back here and do equals and sum product. So that gives me 0. So apparently Excel doesn't treat this as true and false in the correct way. So let's just do a quick conversion here. So I'm gonna put this contacts and this equals A2 in parentheses, and then add double negative to convert them to ones and zeros explicitly. So see, now I get my 2, 4, 1, etc. That now works. So basically what I would have to do here to make this same formula work in Excel, I'm gonna go back to this and see how I did this sum product right here, and I got this contacts array right in here. So I'll just take this contacts list and put it in parentheses from both sides. So now I have one extra parenthesis here and an extra parenthesis in the beginning that jumped over here. And in front of that, I'm just going to do double negative to make sure I convert that to ones and zeros. Hit enter. And now we should get the same results. So if I look at this, then go back to our Google Sheet, we should have the same results. And by the way, that Excel formula that worked here should also work in Google Sheets. So while Google Sheets formula apparently had a little problem working in Excel, we can copy this formula and we should be able to put that same formula here in Google Sheets with those double negatives, and it should still work just fine here. So there it is. We have now one formula compatible for both, and that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.